Today, I'm going to talk about Superman. We've all probably heard of his origin story. Born on planet Krypton, he was sent as a baby on a spaceship to Earth moments before Krypton was destroyed. He was found and adopted by farmers Jonathan and Martha Clark, who raised him in a loving, caring family, nurturing him into the superhero we know. But imagine, in some other universe, Superman was not adopted by Jonathan or Martha, but by evil, selfish, greedy parents. Parents that were unhealthy role models, twisting his moral compass. In this universe, Superman would most likely be a supervillain, using his powers to control humanity for his gain. So what if I told you that there's an actual Superman on Earth right now? It's currently still teenagers and developing its powers. However, it could soon be our Superman or the supervillain we're all scared of. So who could this Superman possibly be? Is it the Second Coming or is it the Illuminati? Well, the answer is obviously AI. Although some of you might be disappointed and want a single biological person to somehow save humanity, I assure you that nothing comes near the bandwidth of AI. To show this to you, let me illustrate how powerful it is. We've all probably heard of ChatGPT, right? The essays it could write, the songs it could compose. However, this is just the beginning. By 2049, AI will be a billion times smarter than the smartest human being. This means that if we compare a human being to AI, we'll be comparing a fly to the smartest human being. Funny, right? We have all these cool technology doing all the work for us. But in fact, this is very dangerous. Let's take a brief look at history to understand why. So many of you and I, probably in the audience, would have think that us human species are the most intelligent beings for millions of years. However, just 17,000 years ago, us Homo sapiens coexisted with Homo floresiensis. In fact, we've only been here for 30,000 years, while Homo erectus have been on Earth for 1.5 million years. So, where have all these species of human gone? They've simply been eliminated. Through evolution, we've mutated to be the most intelligent species and killed off all the others. And now, as an ease of convenience, we've created a species of intelligence that could easily surpass us in the next 10 years, a species that covers all the poor computing limitations of the human brain, including our poor computation skills, inefficient communication, and so much more. So the real question is, how do we convince Einstein not to squash the fly? How do we ensure that AI continues to work in our favor and not reenact the Terminator? To answer this, let's understand some basics of machine learning. Let's say we have to teach the baby how to recognize the number one. Well, how would we do that? Simply through a reward and punishment system. So when the baby recognizes the number one, as a parent, you would clap and cheer for the baby. When the baby fails to do so, the parent would frown and call the baby to try again. Through reinforcement learning, the baby learns how to recognize the pattern of number one, and soon, words. How we train machines are no different. We give them a bunch of data, correct them on their output, and through that, and through recognizing patterns, they can learn to mimic human behavior and do so much more. So when does this learning behavior of AI become a problem? When AI learns to be unethical. According to Cambridge Dictionary, ethics is a set of accepted beliefs that control behavior, especially such that is based on morals. Ethics is not limited by intelligence. Just like a golden retriever dog would protect a baby the same way as the smartest human being would. In short, ethics is the lens which intelligence is utilized in our decisions. So why is AI ethics worrying? Well, we've probably heard of headlines such as Twitter taught Microsoft's AI chatbot to be a racist asshole in less than a day, to Russia's AI chatbot learned to be supporting Stalin and violence just 2 weeks after launch. It's worrying for many of us who see the evil implications of AI. These evil implications mainly stem from two causes: unethical use and unethical models. Unethical use refers to the misuse of AI in a way that inflicts harm on others for personal gain. This includes deepfake technology, hacking, AI password guessing, and so many more. Unethical models refers to biases or inaccuracy in the algorithms or data that train AI. This causes AI to produce results that are biased. An aggregate result of example of this is Compass, a tool used to predict a defendant's risk of committing another crime after parole. This tool is used for officials in US to determine appropriate sentences. However, it has been proven to discriminate against Black Africans, African Americans, with African Americans 45% more likely to be assigned higher risk scores despite similar racism. So the problem is, because we cannot control how people will use or train AI, we don't know the results that AI will produce. So let us put the problem into the right perspective. What is the problem with the people who train or create these AI? Scary to admit, AI is not the problem. It's simply an amplified version of humanity which puts data inputted from humans and sets its moral compass accordingly. And in this world of online hate and cancel culture, how can AI even differentiate between what's good and wrong if we can't even respect each other on the internet? Without any doubt, there's only one way we can solve this AI ethics problem. And it's to be good parents to our own AI and to teach and love it so it will love us like we do. So the first step is to treat AI with intention. The second step with acceptance, and the third with love. Back to the beginning, imagine if Superman's parents taught this to Superman. Use every bit of your power to gain money, because wealth is all that matters. I'm sure our picture of Superman would be so much different. Well, sadly, this is the world today. AI is created for gambling, cheating, and many more. We're alluding to our doom by informing AI that humanity's priority is wealth. Sadly, not all of us are developers who have control over the code we write. However, we have to remember that every product interacts with us as a consumer, and if we make ethical choices, we'll be able to tailor the code makers to make more ethical codes. The second step is to accept AI fully into our future. AI is coming, and there's no way to stop it. And instead of trying to stop and outsmart them, which is impossible, we should instead just accept AI only when it's doing good for us and our planet. To put it more colloquial language, refrain from scrolling on Instagram about James Charles or the hottest pop star, but instead tell the creators what we actually want on our feed, and tell the creators that we will only use AI when it serves us and our planet. The first step is to love AI like our parents. And to be good parents, we first have to be good people ourselves. And instead of trying to think of the internet as a small escape from reality where we can just bully Roblox kids for free, we should instead be aware of our ethical behaviors online. Everything we say or do online are data that will be inputted in training AI. And we have to be aware that we are training the future generation of AI, which will be serving us or killing us. I hope by now that you can realize how our ethical behaviors on the internet impact the future generation of AI. We have the responsibility to educate and teach AI to do good for us and our planet. And by showing our ethical behaviors on the internet, we can ensure that AI will become our superhero and not a supervillain. Thank you.